Hello guys, welcome to Tesca Technologies Private Limited. Today I will going to perform the experiment of FET amplifier. So FET means field effect transistor amplifier. So as we know, the FET amplifier can operate in three configuration, that is common drain, common source and common gate. So the most frequently used configuration is the common source configuration. So FET amplifier have a good gain and it have a input impedance high and output impedance high. So now I am going to move to the kit.
So the order code for this kit is C6142.
With this kit we provide some patch codes. This is an user manual for your understanding. So on the front panel of this kit, that is FET amplifier, we have a FET amplifier circuit. This circuit is designed as we can get the output gain between the 6 to 10. So now I am going to perform some experiment using this kit and the manual. So first of all, I am going to measure the voltage gain of FET amplifier. So for that I am connecting we need a DSO, a function generator. So this is a DSO and this is a function generator. So for first experiment, that is to measure the output voltage gain of FET amplifier, I need some patch codes. So connect the function generator to the input of the circuit to give the sine wave as an input of 1 kilohertz. Connect the 3K9 resistor to the drain terminal of FET and source terminal of BFW10 to the 820 ohm resistor. Now connect the output of the CRO to the output of the circuit. Now turn on the function generator and set the waveform of sine frequency, sine wave, that is frequency of 1 kilohertz. So here it is the frequency of 1 kilohertz. Now read the procedure of the manual. So according to the procedure, select the voltage of sine wave using this function generator at 0.01 volt. So here I am setting the voltage at 0.01 volt. So this is an 0.01 volt. Now turn on the kit. Now as I am increasing this voltage, so by step I am going to increase the amplitude of the sine wave using this function generator. So here I have the voltage of 0.4 volt. So at the in the output we get the peak to peak voltage, that is 2.46 volt. Now again I am increasing the voltage using this function generator. For example, here I am giving the voltage of 0.7 volt. So in output we are getting the voltage of 3.9 volt. So if you measure the gain, that is V output upon V input, then you get the result of gain in between 6 to 10. So this is the voltage gain of FET amplifier. Now I am going to measure the frequency response of FET amplifier. So for that I am increasing the frequency of sine wave using this function generator. So in output we are going to see the gain. So this is the frequency response of FET amplifier. So now I am going to continuously increasing the frequency of sine wave. From 50 hertz to 50 kilohertz. So for example, here I am giving the frequency of sine wave is at 10 kilohertz. So you can see in output the voltage is of 3.7 volt. Similarly, now I am going to increasing the sine wave frequency. So here I am giving the frequency of 20 kilohertz. So you can see in output we are getting the voltage of 3.1. So this is the frequency response of FET amplifier. So now in next experiment I am going to measure the input impedance of FET amplifier. So to measure the input impedance we need a decade resistance box. So this is a decade resistance box of Tesca. So now I am going to connect the decade resistance box at the input of circuit. So as you can see, before the connection of decade resistance box we have the output voltage is of 3.1 volt. So here the voltage is of 3.16 volt. Now I am going to vary the different resistance value using this decade resistance box so that the output voltage become half. So here we have the connection of decade resistance box to the input to measure the input impedance. Now I am going to take the different value of decade resistance box and the value at which the output becomes half, that is our input impedance. So here I am giving the resistance of 100 ohm. In output we have a 860 millivolt. So at 200 ohm the output become half. So this is the input impedance of FET amplifier. So you can see it is the knob is at 200 ohm. At 200 ohm we have the half voltage of 3.12 volts. So this is the measurement of FET input impedance. Similarly, I am going to connect the decade resistance box in parallel to the output to measure the output impedance of FET amplifier. So before connection of decade resistance box we have the output voltage is of 3.1 volt. Now I am going to, so before connection of DRBC in parallel with output we have a voltage of 3.1 volt. Now I am going to connect the decade resistance box in parallel with the output and we set that value of decade resistance box at the resistance where the output becomes half. So to measure the output impedance I am going to connect the decade resistance box in parallel to the output. Now I am taking different value where the output becomes half. So here So in decay resistance box, I have selected the value of 20K. So at 20K, I am getting the half voltage of output. Before the decay resistance box connection, we have the voltage of 3.2 volt. After the decay resistance box connection, we have the voltage of 1.5. So this is the measurement of output impedance where the output voltage becomes half. So this is all about the FET amplifier. So thank you for watching this video. For other queries, you can contact Tesca Technologies Private Limited, and you can also go through our manuals. Thank you.